Listening Library presents Who's in Love with Arthur, Book Number 10, by Marc Brown, read by Marc Linn-Baker.
Chapter 1. Outside Lakewood Elementary School, it was raining hard. But inside the gym, it was nice and dry, and the students were dancing to country music. Square dancing was a school tradition on rainy days. Mrs. McGrady, who ran the school cafeteria, was their caller. She led them through the different steps. "Swing your partner round and round," she said. "That's it. Keep swinging." Arthur and Francine were managing their swing nicely, but not all the couples in their square were as good. As Binky swung Muffy around, her feet kept leaving the ground.
"Not so fast, Binky," Muffy complained. "I'm not a helicopter."
Mrs. McGrady clapped her hands.
"Side couples, up to the middle, high five, and now scoot back."
Binky lumbered forward, yanking Muffy along with him.
"Look out," she cried as she was hurled off balance into Francine.
"Hey," said Francine, "watch it."
Muffy slowly picked herself up.
"It's not my fault," she said. "Binky threw me."
Arms swinging madly, Binky hoedowned backward to his spot. His elbow knocked the brain to one side. The brain stepped on Sue Ellen's foot. Sue Ellen slipped and fell onto Francine. In another moment, they were all slipping, falling, and most of all, complaining. Mrs. McGrady shut off the boombox.
"I think that's enough for today," she said. "You were all very light on your feet," she glanced at Binky. "And I know the rest of you are trying your best."
Gym was the last class of the day. All the kids returned to Mr. Ratburn's classroom to gather their things before the bell rang.
"Did you say something?" Francine asked Muffy as she passed Muffy's desk.
"No," said Muffy.
After Mr. Ratburn dismissed them, Francine, Muffy, and Arthur headed for the schoolyard.
"You're doing it again," said Francine.
"Doing what?" asked Muffy.
"Mumbling."
Francine folded her arms.
"Come on, what's the matter?"
Muffy folded her arms, too.
"Well, if you must know, I was just saying what a crummy day this was."
Arthur nodded. "I don't like the rain, either."
"No, not that," said Muffy. "I'm talking about the dancing."
"Oh, that," said Francine, laughing. "You did have your hands full. But I think Binky's getting better." Muffy snorted.
"Maybe so, but I don't know if I'll survive another hoedown like that."
She suddenly brightened.
"Hey, Arthur, next time we have square dancing, will you be my partner?"
Arthur shrugged.
"Okay," he said.
"Wait a second," said Francine, frowning. "If you're dancing with Arthur, who's going to be my partner?"
At that moment, Binky burst through the door behind them. His shoelaces were untied, and as he came down the steps, he tripped and tumbled to the ground. Shaking his head, he bounced up a moment later.
"I did that on purpose," he said. "Either that, or the step moved."
Muffy smiled at Francine.
"And you were wondering about a partner?"
"Oh, no," said Francine. "My health insurance isn't that good. I'm sticking with Arthur."
Arthur looked from one friend to the other.
"Don't I get a say in this?" he asked.
"No," said Francine.
"But..."
Muffy started to argue.
"Come on, Arthur," Francine cut in. "I'll give you a lift home."
Francine dragged Arthur away to the street corner where her father was waiting in his garbage truck. Arthur looked back once, but when he saw the expression on Muffy's face, he didn't look back again. Chapter 2. Muffy sat down on a bench and sighed. The rain had stopped, and the sun was peeking out from behind the clouds, but that didn't help. Her mood was still dark.
"Boy, do my feet hurt," she said.
Maybe your shoes are too tight, said Binky, coming up behind her.
He had retied his sneakers, but one of the knots was already coming loose again. These are very expensive shoes, Muffy explained. They envelop my feet in a cocoon of comfort. It says so right on the box.
Oh, said Binky, who never thought about enveloping his feet in anything but socks. Your feet must be hurting for some other reason, then.
Yes, Muffy agreed, some other reason, like a dancing partner who's always stepping on my toes.
Binky nodded. Not very considerate. You should tell... Hey, that couldn't be it. I mean, I was your dancing partner.
I know.
Binky looked confused.
But I didn't feel a thing.
I know, Muffy repeated.
Huh, said Binky, scratching his head. I guess I don't know my own strength.
Muffy sighed. That's okay. I know you're doing the best you can.
That's right, said Binky.
But when Mrs. McGrady says, swing your partner, she doesn't mean my feet should leave the floor.
I noticed no one else was doing it my way. I just figured their partners weren't strong enough.
Muffy stood up and began to pace. It's not really your fault, Binky. The one I should be mad at is Francine.
Binky nodded. She stepped on your toes too, huh? He said knowingly.
No, she's a good dancer. It's just that she won't share Arthur with me. I mean, he's not her personal property. So why should she get to decide who he dances with? The way she acts, you'd think they were married or something.
Married? Said Binky, horrified. No way.
Muffy rolled her eyes. Well, of course they're not really married, but Francine sure acts like she owns him, and she wasn't afraid to tell me to keep my hands off.
Francine always speaks her mind, Binky agreed. I never have to wonder what she's thinking, because she always lets me know. But she's good at sharing. So why won't she change partners with you?
Muffy looked sideways at Binky. I wonder. Well, I'd better get going. I've got ballet class in an hour. She glanced down. My feet are going to love that. As Muffy rode off on her bike, Binky stood for a moment, thinking. Suddenly,
we hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.